team-wise? Is it camaraderie? Is it the spirit of the program? Enthusiasm,
our emotion, our teamwork, our unity as a team. Just everybody on the team, it's just like a big family. Everybody knows everything about everybody. We get together, we all go out, and just a unit. It's just all at one.
Passes, and we're catching some breaks here. We'll need to create something because we aren't getting it going offensively. Here's a take by Loveless. Hey, now we go in the early going. Guerin's got his feet set. When he does, that's what happens. If you let Mike Guerin set his feet and take a look, that's exactly what happened. Casburn is lightning quick, and he's going to shoot it. He's not bashful. How about that? Jet Casburn, his first shot ever as a varsity basketball player, goes in for two. And into Leonard, who kicks it out. Guerin will try another three. Boom, baby! Mike Guerin got six. Ryan Smith up high with it. They'll lay off Rhino. They know he's not going to shoot the three. Here's a lob to Rhino. He can do it down. What a pass to Craig Snow!
That was great.
So far this year, 1994-95, what's been one or even more than one, your most memorable experiences from playing basketball this year?
Probably the most memorable would be my first basket, because it was the first basket of the 95-94 season.
Craig Smith, 18-footer right side, won't go. Mike Guerin, though, has got the offensive board. His putback is good, and Mike Guerin scores the first 2 points of the 94 season.
So what are the positive changes you see from the new program and the new system we have now?
Everybody's working harder than I've ever seen Mount Carmel play. And it's more enthusiastic around all the town. And I just think everybody's into basketball now instead of just football in Mount Carmel.
To Snow, who's got a wide open Luke Leonard on the other side. Leonard has two.
I was kind of hoping Luke would reverse that like he did the other night. Use the old double hand reverse.
Pointer left side, no good for this Luke. He's rebounded. Smith, he's got a man wide open. There's a quarterback for you. A wide open Travis Bates. We'll keep the full court pressure on. There's a diving Luke Leonard. Boy,
I think sometimes he has a mental lapse and forgets what sport he's in, Coach.
He was going for the tackle there on that one.
Yeah. If he was in football, when Coach Johnson's talking to him there, that may have been by the face mask.
It got started off kind of slow, and we just progressively blew him away. Here's another three for Ted Case.
Won't go. Rebounded out of there. Blitz.
Here we're running.
Lob to Taylor, who'll go in all the way. Chris Taylor's got two. We'll be atop the league. We'll try to find out how Fairfield did tonight against...
The reverse!
Yes! Luke Leonard!
I really enjoyed the charge drill in practice. That was always a lot of fun.
How about the team camaraderie this year? The guys, obviously a new situation for you, a whole new group of guys and a whole new school system and a new coach. It was brand new all the way around for you. Your feeling on the team camaraderie this year?
It's been great. I mean, everybody gets along really well. It's really been fun to just all become friends, you know, and we've really molded into a good team, I think.
Here's a three-pointer, blocked by Snow. This could be it. Greg Snow has got the first dunk of the year, and he slams it home.
Money they use from their fundraiser. Come on, get up, Ryan.
Ryan Smith. We're up and good. Boy, we thought he might go for his dunk.
I think he would have.
I think so, too.
You know, how about that? Edwards County got caught behind the bucket. Casburn with it again. He's going to try to...
Oh, nice.
Nice. This to Bates. Now we lead it by 24.
A hustling Fair cannot get a steal. Now he comes back from behind, tries to steal it.
Oh, yeah. Oh, my. Bledsoe comes in right off the bench. He wasn't even loose. I don't see how he hadn't worked up a sweat. Bledsoe's got a three. Well, we're going to need some big shots in a hurry. Bledsoe's going to just come by the way. Bledsoe is in another three. Gotta begin me. He was off balance. He didn't even have the ball in his hands, and he fired it up.
Big turnaround probably be just emotion. Everybody, like most teams, like, you know, if they don't have chemistry like we have, everybody, you know, no one cares who scores. We just want to win, and we want to play together. I mean, even practices are, everybody's loud, everybody, you know,
pat on the butt, good job, hey, high fives. You know, some teams don't have that. They're just like, well, you know, it's another day. Everybody, I mean, everybody here, it's like, you know, we love to come to practice, love to play together. And it's great. And when we come play games and it all just fits right in, it's nice. And coach is probably one of the biggest things, the biggest change. I mean, he turned the program around. Didn't make it just high school players. He got everybody involved from grade school on up. So they can just feed in, not like after, well, you've been taught this, now you're gonna have to learn how to play here. Doesn't matter what your grade school coach has told you. You gotta do things my way. Now that you've been told the same thing, so you already know what to expect. Yes, good chance.
Hey. Bates will set for the three. In and out, Ryan Smith has got it to go. Rhino's got three. It's 20.
Chance to cut it to six, maybe five. Loveless is two on the way.
Go, my!
Make differences, and we've done it.
Case's three on the way is good. Ted Case, you submitted earlier, Coach, he is saving us tonight. He's got 11. Trying to get back in it. We're within seven. We trailed by 14 at the half. Smitty goes strong.
Nice move!
He is so quick on the first step. Case dribbles in. His turnaround. Jay goes good with 4 seconds left. And how about that, Coach? Barring this shot going in, we go to the fourth quarter, down only four.
This could have been a great finish to a ball game.
Exactly. Ryan Smith goes and scores. Now it's seven. Now it's 6-5. Ryan Smith will have to shoot it. And they caught a foul. There's a foul on the Mule. Well, who'd have thought it? Ryan Smith. Played under the weather all game long. He missed practice this morning because he has the flu, and I'll be darned he's going to be at the line with a chance to tie. Smitty will get a shot.
Oh, Nelly, let's be quiet, fellas. Oh, come on, baby.
Yes! Yes! Nails the first. So now it's 59-58. You talk about excitement. And we're tied! We are tied! And we're going to OT, baby! Well, now you need a three. Something to watch. Garen's checked into the game. Mike Garen. Here's a three on the way for Kane!
Oh,
it's good! It's good! It's good! We tied it again, fellas! Woo!
Kind of a unique situation for you, sitting out since your freshman year and deciding to come out and play basketball, shooting, able to come in and contribute right away. What's been a few things that made the transition a little easier for you coming in after setting out two seasons?
I say Coach Johnson, definitely, and a lot of players I knew from when I played my freshman year, and I just get along with everybody, and they accepted just me and Luke from the football team in real easy, just like part of the football team, actually family, so it's real easy coming in.
Loveless right side to look it inside to Snow, but they're not going to be getting many passes into him like that. Three-pointer by Case is good.
Hit perfectly straight. He leaned in and no foul.
There's Snow. He hits the hot man. That's Case for three more. Can hit him. Garen can take it. He's open. There's Snow. He'll take the three. Good. So working it back to this side. There's Case. He's open. He'll take the three. Good. What a game Ted Case is having.
Close quick inbound. Return from Rhino. This three on the way from Case is good. 6:15 left first quarter. Again, a high view for you tonight. Case from deep. He's got three more. Ted Case has six. The Aces on the attack. We're all knotted here. As Ted Case continue his offensive arsenal, he's got nine.
Foul trouble, he's got two.
Case from deep. Oh, my, Coach. Don't cool him off. Let's let him stay hot. He's got 12, 4 3-pointers for Ted Case.
Wide open. I'm going to say, don't leave him open, Mount Vernon.
He has 15 points, Coach. 5 3-pointers.
I've seen you and you've played ball for a long time, man. Is this, when you look back on it now, at least this far, is this kind of how you hoped it end up for you as a senior?
Yeah, it's been pretty good. And, you know, I'm really glad that we got Coach Johnston, you know, or that would come in here and change things the way he has, and it's really been for the better.
Talk about the atmosphere and the attitude of the town concerning basketball nowadays. It's a heck of a lot different than you're probably used to.
Definitely. I mean, you know, like if I go to work, you know, like the day after a game or something, you know, I have a lot of people talking about the game last night. I mean, people I don't even know, you know, told me, hey, good game, you know, and you guys are looking pretty good, you know, and I mean, it's a lot different. Whereas, you know, before you don't really, people don't take a lot of interest in it. I mean, we've had the gym packed so many times. It's great.
You better shoot it at the buzzer. Oh,
kill it, baby!
Oh, yeah! A little tough going on the offense, man. Really, for both teams. Levels are going up. Nice look to his teammate, Justin Loveless. Looks like Loveless came to play tonight. He's got five.
Marvelous game. It's Bates, and Smith, and there's Loveless. With the point, now Case finds it on the high post, drop down.
That's
Loveless.
Twice we've seen that work already. Loveless has got 11.
Now on the Aces baseline, Loveless triggers. Inside, Smith.
I don't know how many times, I can't even count, I've seen that inbounds play work this year from day one.
From side court, Loveless triggers to Smith, back to Justin, works the weak side, pumps it up, off the glass and in! What a shot by Loveless! Holy mackerel, and the foul's on Aldi!
As you look back on this year, what's been some of the more memorable experiences for you playing basketball for the Aces?
Well, team-wise, probably anybody would say the beating the Indians up there at Lawrenceville and beating the Mules up there at Fairfield. That's some of the greatest times I ever had in basketball. Great excitement. Individually, I've had quite a few great games where I've really stepped up. It's just been a great year. Really fun.
He eyes it. He skies it.
Hey, he got it.
And the crowd loves it. He's trying not to smile.
His dad just did the wave.
He's trying not to smile. But Aaron has, you know, he knows he's excited. And there's another one.
Hey, you got both of them. Look at that, doing the wave.
2 of 2 at the line for Berberick, and it's 68-37. Mount Carmel with 2 minutes to go. Casper spins his way to the crease. Kicks it across the floor. There's a grab. Haywood bites through traffic.
Hey, get his 2 points.
He hit an unbelievable shot considering he was mugged going in. Here comes Haynes. Well, Mount Carmel is hungry for a winner in basketball.
Oh, nice Haynes move. Yep. Oh, that was sweet. He switched that with hands up there and used the body and a whole bunch of other good stuff.
That was a highlight film right there. 64-35, 8.
All right, I won't bet anything. I got in trouble last time I did that, but... Brian Andrews, yes sir, great rebound, great
Andrews
position.
Andrews has too. Now that. To sleep around, if you don't expect too much from me, you might not be let down. Cause all I really want to be with you, feel like I matter to defy and bloom the whole thing here.
You're an interesting case that started off playing a lot of junior varsity ball early on, and now you're an integral part of the varsity squad, really. One of the top 7 guys that sees the most playing time. What have you done, or what has the coaching staff done for you to help, for you to have the vast improvement that you've had this season?
The coach gave me a lot of confidence, and he's worked with me on offense and defense fundamentally, and then going against Craig Snow every day, one-on-one in practice, that's got to make you better.
Off Bates, back to Snow, an 18-footer good. He was at one step inside the line, and in the Carmel Invitational when we played these dogs. 5-2, and Bates goes all the way. Nice take for the senior point guard.
For a young kid, third grader, basketball player comes up to you and says, Travis, I want to play for the Varsity Aces one day. What do I have to do to get to that goal? What would be some advice you'd give a youngster?
Just to work as hard as you can and just work on the things you need to, and you should make it.
Snow down low. That one goes good. He was with Snow, Case, and Bates. Snow goes strong, nice. Count it, and he'll go to the line to shoot one. Snow's got eight with a chance to make it nine, and now it's 25-20. We're within five.
And pressure. Trying to free up Snow, a little off balance, but it goes good. It's important because we play them on Tuesday, of course, at their place. Craig Snow, now that's a big-time move. Now at 10, now we'll go. Craig Snow, one-on-one, pulls up from three.
Oh, my! No, that's a two. That's a two. Is he incredible or what?
Hold that card up. Great enthusiasm from the student body and the home fans. Here from deep as Snow for three.
The season, for some reason, had to end tomorrow for you. Just this season, not your career, but the season, for some reason, came to an end tomorrow. Have you got what you wanted out of this year? I mean, are you happy with your progress as an individual and as a team of where you, how far you've come this year?
Oh, yeah, as a team, I think we've done great. You know, we'd like to have won conference, but I thought we really showed people that because, I mean, nobody expected us to really do a whole lot at the beginning of the season, but like they say, them polls, they don't mean a whole lot, but, I mean, we came out and we didn't listen. We got off right out the gate. We got out real good, started out real nice. I think we won. Before Christmas, we were undefeated, I'm pretty sure, and we cooled off a little bit, but I thought as a team, we really came together, and we've learned that it takes a team to accomplish goals, and but I think we've came together pretty much a lot better than what a lot of people thought we would.
a show. What a sight. What a night. 1967.
I think that'll be our seventh. Coach Johnson might get his first technical as a Golden Ace head coach here, as he's not. Towel, and of course I'm sure he had a few more words as well when he brought out that towel besides here you go sir. I'm sure he let him know because he wanted a charge on that last play, and so when the referee asked for a towel from our bench, Coach Johnson volunteered quite.
We just made the plays when we had to. The ball seemed to bounce the right way, and you know, they're a very good ball club, and you know, they just didn't knock some shots down. I thought we did some things defensively, and I think it took them out of the rhythm a little bit. But again, a big win for our kids. And you know, one of the things we just talked about in the locker room is you're never too high after a win,
right,
and you're never too low after a loss. We threw that out the window tonight, Rob.
And it's all spinning. Now Rick Johnson has drawn a technical. So Coach Johnson gets his first technical of the year. Just a horrible call. That, my friend, was terrible. Now Johnson discussing it. Sitting down, as a matter of fact, I think when he got the call, not often do you see a coach get whistled for a technical when he's setting down. Now did he get whistled for two?
After Coach Johnson turned his back, they give him a second technical. That's not what I'd call a brave official.
Well, I believe if the events have transpired as we believe, he's just been whistled for two technicals. Well, nonetheless, Walters will go to the line to shoot, I believe, four free throws on. 6:16 remains. They're trying to sort it out now. Rick's talking with the other referee. Now, is Rick ejected? Is that the two technicals and you're out of the game? I thought it was three, Coach, although I could be wrong.
Yeah. Must be two now.
So Rick Johnson, well, how about that? Rick Johnson's been ejected here at the 6:16 mark of this ball game.